So neither Sandra or I have ever seen this sled. We bought it from the Netherlands, and we've never seen it in person.
It's a used sled.
Okay. If it was a new sled, it would have cost 80,000 euros. Oh,
is it a winning sled?
It's a winning sled.
Oh, that's always.
Sorry, it's a qualifying sled.
It's a dirty sled.
Oh, we got a free helmet, too. I'm actually very excited
it's
about
like
this.
It's like a Christmas present. Oh, sorry. What is the name? Chanukah.
No,
yes.
You don't.
Yes, Chanukah present.
Okay.
One,
two, three.
Phew. Ooh, right.
Why is it orange?
In Israel, there is one very small place that has a quarter of an inch of snow a couple of days a year. Skeleton and bobsled are just brutal sports. From a funding standpoint, it's terrifying.
Not sure if you need to be optimistic or just crazy. Somehow, somewhere in between.
For me, that's what the sport is. It's controlled chaos, the ability to overcome danger, to rise above and have fearlessness. It's the perfect sport for an Israeli. I have never been the best in the sport and never will be the best at the sport. But I can confidently say no one works harder than me in my sport. So I will tell them to bring jackets.
Some gloves.
I'm sure none of them have gloves. I have to work a normal job to support the team.
And we can pay the 20,000.
So I work 8 hours a day. And then after, I spend 5, 6, 7, 8 hours on team-related issues.
Gotten a bit beat up, but we repurpose everything that we possibly can.
Throw in 2 hours of training. That's 18. I'm lucky if I get 6 hours of sleep. We don't have a team manager. We don't have a coach now. I do everything. It's tough. You know, for a while, I was driving for Uber to try to help the team out.
Is the Google form all I need to do to kind of reserve space?
You'll need to find a waiver.
I haven't had a home for the last 7, 8 years. I'm on the road all the time, moving from place to train, to compete, and do whatever is needed to represent.
Hey, Dad.
Hey, AJ. How are you, honey?
I'm doing pretty well. About to head off to Israel to find our team, to recruit our team. Very excited about it. We have a series of combines coming up. I'm nervous, but
that's great.
Pretty excited about it.
Thank you for your cooperation. So please place your roller box in the open bins. Walls your handles first so we can come in.
How are you?
I'm very good. I'm in Israel right now. So I just wanted to check in about the color samples.
You want two designs, so...
It might be a little expensive for us, so we'll have to pick and choose.
All right. Thanks. Take care.
The budget is incredibly detailed. Helmets, suits, burn vests, Kevlar vests. How am I going to raise the money? I don't know. I only raised 12% last season. 3% of that was from my grandfather. I really don't know how I'm gonna raise the money. I'm trying. We're getting like a used four-man sled. It will cost us $25,000. I've already paid one-third of that. I'm looking for the other two-thirds of that. This is what I work on morning till night. Oh, that reminds me. I haven't filed the insurance from the season. My heart is in the east. Always. How do you explain to someone that this is the only country for you? Especially when you weren't born there. You spent 23 years elsewhere. I was born in Boston, Massachusetts, and I went to school in Boston, university in Boston. Best day of my life is when I became an Israeli citizen. There's no words for the connection that I think an Israeli can feel towards his country. It's coming home, and it's my love. For me, representing Israel is a very important career choice, and it is a career. I found bobsled and skeleton and fell in love with it, and there started my journey. I was told originally I couldn't do bobsled because it was too short and too small. Do it on your own on the lunch tray. See how that goes.
Speed up for me. Okay, have fun.
Here we go.
Feet down.
I thought, what better a way to prove that we can do anything we want than overcoming the worst scouting report that's been given to an Olympic skeleton athlete. And that meant making the Olympics with a big Star of David on my back. The Olympics in 2018 were a tough one. There was an unfortunate series of events that pushed me out of the sport. But I thought, if I stop now, Israel will not be best represented. So in January of 2019, I took a look at what we had for a bobsled team. Skeleton was hard, but bobsled takes it to another level.
One of my roles in life is to push Israel forward in sport in ways that others cannot. Someone needs to be a stepping stone to pave the way. I'll do whatever it takes.
He was not gonna pick up, I guarantee. It's the welder, the guy who's making the sled. It's very clear we need it on the 29th. Yeah, like it's clearly not completed. The wheels are not on. The testing is only today. This is the reason to come to Israel in the first place. Not having a push sled makes it like anyone could have just sent in a video. Like, why was I here? This is the current status. I'm really gonna be embarrassed. How's a country supposed to make the Olympics if we have no money, like, I don't know. It's why it sucks to be like just the one person doing everything. Kind of a bad way to start the day.
This sport is known as a skill transfer sport, meaning if you competed in a previous sport and you have good athletic ability, you can transfer that athletic ability to bobsled.
Nice to meet you too. Okay, so for now, just warm up because the sprint starts at 5.
Okay.
But it's built.
It's okay.
It works. אני חשבתי בבוקר שאני הולך למות כי זה הדבר הראשון שאנו צריכים. It's the centerpiece. לספורטאים אנו צריכים לדחוף בזחלה.
Goodbye.
That's 30. Grab the conus.
9 different athletes will be at the testing events. A couple of shot putters, a discus thrower, people from the CrossFit community. But I went looking for national team rugby athletes. I essentially direct messaged them on Instagram.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to the combine, the first. This is a big deal, as you see. We are surrounded by some excellent settings today, though it's hot as blazes. The combine will go with a series of tests. The first is from a standing position, 30 meters, 3 times. So it'll go in, I guess, the random order you guys have assigned yourselves, from 1 to 8. Bobsled's a really, really difficult sport. Minus 25 is expected on temperatures. So if you don't really like cold temperatures, it's quite tough. To push a bobsled, you need strong legs, you need powerful legs, and you need an iron will.
All of the hard work, all of the pain is worth it if it just leaves one positive thing. Israel needs this. I know a lot of people don't think Israel needs this, but Israel needs this.
Hi, I'm AJ.
Hey, I'm Roman.
Amit.
Well,
Amitai.
Menachem.
And that's Lulu.
Lulu.
And we are Bob Team Israel, Bob Team Edelman.
We're about 25, 30 minutes outside of Calgary. We have to be here because it's cheap to be out here. So 9 people in a house, it's exorbitantly expensive. Almost all of the guys have never even seen ice before, let alone run on ice. So we have a couple weightlifters and we have a rugby player. So I'm nervous, but I'm also really excited because the unveiling of the sled, them seeing the track, them understanding what it takes, I think it gets most athletes really amped up.
Sandra's a great coach. She's really good. My confidence shot up when we got her, and it's incredible to have an Olympic champion as part of your team.
Normal bobsleigh nations, there are more people in the team, more stuff. So I get the shoes from my former teammates. They send me at home, so I bring a lot of stuff. I try to help. It's a special thing because I'm a German, and the Germans from the history have a special situation with Israel or Jewish people. And 2022, it's exactly 50 years after the Olympic Games in Munich. A German girl trained an Israel team for the Olympics. It's like goosebumps, you know?
Should we walk to the cryo zone or walk down through the track?
So we're going this way.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, this is not the start. This is the end.
No, it's the end. Understand. I thought
the finish was...
Yeah, the finish is there. You can see how a corner works or how pressure works. Yeah. They come in, have the high, then you lose the pressure, the sled comes down, yeah. You go in with steering, you leave it, then you get the high later, and then you can easy turn.
Got it. After you're inside the sled, you put your head between your legs and you pray.
This is the corner when we maybe watched a movie from Cool Runnings.
They crash here.
They crashed in this exit. Now when you stay in, you can see how big this corner is.
It takes like 5 seconds. It's the longest corner I've ever been on. We're going to go see our sled. We have a naming competition. And whoever comes up with the best name, I don't know, I'll make you a sushi dinner or something because I'm a sushi chef. All right, let's go.
L.L. Israel.
Let's go find this sled. Probably take it to a car wash or something.
First part, cleaning. Orange and blue looks good.
I was thinking maybe spray paint. This is our new toy. It's our new baby.
Yes.
The first time ever running on ice.
Try. So only use in front, you know. Don't do this. So try to run a little. How it's the feeling. Stop. Perfect. With this, you use the clean, all it's out. Because when it's full, yeah, perfect. And now, first push.
This is his first ever push, so.
Start like this. It's like, boom. Try it.
Like you feel it like escaping from you.
Looking forward, we're going to continue to build on this momentum. This team is a culmination of more than 20 months of painstaking work where at times I've wanted to literally lay down and die. And all of the work has led to this point. I don't see a way in which all of that effort and all of the talent we have and all the pieces in place lead to non-success. We are going to make it.
Ready, and boom!
Okay, not bad.
Cheese.
Cheese.